Hey, stream daft. It looks good. Alright, Argus is in the water, going down.
Roger that. This is an audio slate for dive H1900. UTC time is 22:37:06. Mark.
Deck is all stop 50 meters. You ready for control? Go ahead, bump it.
Audio check, 1-2, 1-2, audio check.
Good afternoon, everyone, on the 12 to 4 watch. For those of you who are just joining, we are on our fourth dive of the Lu'u Aea Ahiki Ike Kualona Kai expedition. We just launched our vehicles about 20 minutes ago or so, and we are going to be descending down to another unnamed seamount, Seamount D. And we will do kind of a similar transect as we have for the last three dives. We'll work upslope from around 3,500 meters in depth to the summit, at approximately 1,700 meters in depth, and we'll be identifying different benthic fauna, characterizing the ecosystems, and different sponge coral and other sea creatures we may see, as well as trying to better understand the geology of these deep seamounts. So thanks for joining us today. We've probably got a couple hours till the bottom. So if you have any questions for the blue water, we always welcome them to keep us entertained as we descend. I think while we're starting, maybe we'll do some introductions of our 12 to 4 watch. My name is Kelly Farron. I'm sitting in the science communication seat, and I'm sitting in the back row. I'm going to pass it over to Steve, who is our watch lead.
Hello, everyone. Steve Oskovich here, watch lead and science manager for 12 to 4. I am a deep water ecologist focusing on biology and biogeography of deep water corals. So I'm excited to be here leading this dive. I think we had a pretty spectacular biology represented in the past couple of dives, and I'm looking forward to seeing what's in this site. To my immediate right.
Oh.
Hi, everyone. I'm Ashley Mickens. I'm a graduate student at the University of Victoria in British Columbia. On board, I'm the ocean science intern and data logger. Very happy to be here.
Front row, you want to do some introductions? Maybe we'll start with video.
Sure. This is Steven Matter in the video chair. Happy to be here.
Hello, Josh Chernov. I'm sitting the Argus seat and the OET ROV operations manager for the Trust.
I'm Gabby Inglis. I'm in the Herc seat.
My name is Kate von Krusenstern, and I'm sitting in the nav seat for OET today.
Thanks, everyone. Welcome back to the control van. I already have a question for maybe our ROV pilots. Some people are wondering how Herc is connected to the crane when we lower the ROVs into the water.
Josh, you want to field this one?
Sure.
You're more of a rigger than I am.
Anyway, I'll fix that later. How is Herc connected to the crane? So we use, the crane has a winch on it, and the winch has a high strength synthetic line. And we use that with a release. So you connect the release to the lift bail, that little, if you see it on the launch, you'll see a kind of a ring on the top of Hercules. It's a titanium lift bail is what we call it, so it's connected into the frame of the vehicle so we can lift the whole vehicle just from that one point. And the release goes through that, which is connected to the crane. And once when you have the weight on, the release won't release. And once the relay comes off, you'll see somebody pull kind of a string, and that pops the release and lets Herc go. So that's how we have it connected to the crane, and then when we're in the water and the weight comes off the vehicle, because of course it floats in water, it will let it go, pop that release, and off it drives.
Thanks, Josh. If you guys look at our quad view, Steve pulled up a picture so you can kind of see what we were talking about.